Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. David Fuller here with Eyes on the Sky, and wanted to share with you an idea that my wife Kimberly and I had that we would like to further implement for helping people be able to see more of the night sky, because we live under Bortle 4 skies, which is a rural transition type of area, so the Milky Way is visible. It's not as bright as Bortle 1 or Bortle 2, but it's way better than even Bortle 5, where my friend Dave and I used to live, where my friend Dave lives. You can notice a difference. You can only see 90 degrees of the Milky Way there. Here you can see about 160 degrees of the Milky Way, so that's pretty good. And it's much brighter. And what we also wanted to be able to do was show people how to star hop using simple binoculars, just like these. These are just Celestron, Cometron, 7x50 binoculars. Very simple. Bought a bunch of them so that way everyone would have the exact same experience, because they'd be able to use the binoculars that are the exact same ones I'm pointing things out with and be able to show them things in the night sky. So what we've done is a couple of things. Number one, we have completely transformed our property. So right behind me, let's see if you can see this over here. This area of our property we left. This still has a bunch of goldenrod and things on it of that nature. And there was a lot of that along with dogwood and some other just underbrush stuff that really didn't belong here, because this is prairie. This was originally prairie, and we want to restore a lot of this to prairie. So if you look out over this way, and hopefully the sun doesn't kill it too much, we completely leveled all that, which is great. We have one little section over here, which we still need to have hit again. The guy that brought out the forestry mulcher to do it, his hydraulic line broke, so he couldn't quite finish it. He's coming back out to finish that up. So that's kind of where we are with that. But I want to show you this idea that we have. It goes down the southeastern part of the property. We have a shed, which the shed is useful for holding, obviously, things to cut the grass and, you know, get rid of some of the trees and things like that. Small trees or cut branches. But more importantly, we want to sort of use this as an area that we can have be used for astronomy. And it has worked well for that, both for, you know, having some friends over, but also we did a meetup group. The nice thing about the meetup group is that we had a bunch of people come out, and it was cold, but we have a heater. So that worked well to be able to have them just be able to hang out, still warm up, see the nice sky. What we did with that, though, was we had an indoor presentation first, brought them out to the property. They could see the dark sky, used the binoculars, showed them a number of objects, and then we went back inside for the remainder of the presentation. We wanted to try to just do everything outside. So how did we do that? Well, I'm going to show you very quickly in 2 minutes. What I did to make that happen. So here we go. Thank you. That is a 200-inch screen diagonally. So it's about 14 feet wide and almost 8 feet tall. So it's large. It's actually larger than I expected it to be. It wound up that the shed is just slightly smaller than I expected, but it works. So yay. And what's exciting about that is anyone who is in the Chicago area, Bloomington, Champaign, because we're kind of equidistant from all those areas, that has more light pollution, we want to invite them, or if you happen to be passing through and are able to stop by for one of our meetups at the time, we want to have you come out here. I'll do a presentation over on the screen, and then you'll literally be right here, and hopefully we'll have clear skies, obviously, because it is the Midwest, and you never know. But with clear skies, you'll be able to literally look up, use binoculars, and see those objects immediately. And that's something that we think is a little different than what probably anyone else is offering. Now, maybe someone else does this. If they do, I'm not aware of it. Most things start inside and then go outside. So we're going to try to do one where everything's just outside. Even if it's cold, we won't do bitterly cold, obviously. But even in cold weather, you know, people bundled up and we had the heater and they were warm and things worked. So that is the new plan. And I hope you will be able to join us for that. If not, I'm going to do a bunch of other content and help you be able to still find things in the night sky as well. And for that, I will obviously ask you to, you know, if you're not already a subscriber, please hit the subscribe button, like this video, and like the future ones that are coming your way. And with that, keep your eyes on the sky, your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. And I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.